everyone! Today's tutorial is about a new function to create labels or stickers or even buttons with dynamic text. This feature was already introduced in one of the last updates of 2019, and we shortly mentioned it in a blog post a couple of weeks ago, but we feel it's such a big change that can potentially save you all so much work and time that we needed to dedicate a whole video tutorial to it. This is the blog post that introduced this feature, amongst many other of that update, and it's this one, auto-detected titles and subtitles. So as this suggests, the idea is to insert in our skin text elements which are dynamic, so whose content updates or feeds automatically from specified property of our media, so of our panoramas, videos, photos, etc. In this case, and for now, we started with the parameters title and subtitle, so you no longer have to create individual title tags for each and every single panorama in your tour and then show hide the corresponding tag. Now it's much easier, as it'll be just one general tag which auto-updates the content according to the currently playing media. Here's what I mean. I'm sure you remember our typical luxury real estate sample here, which is a few years old already. Each panorama has its own sticker with the title of the current position and a short explanation. See, as we change rooms, the sticker changes too. So back then, to achieve this, we had to create a general container in our skin called sticker, in which we inserted all the different images or text elements of our stickers, one for each panorama. And then in each panorama we had to define that it'll show only that exact corresponding sticker with the room title and hides all of the other ones. So it was quite a bit of work to create and import all these different stickers, sort them, and then switch them on and off in the correct panoramas. But now let's see how we can do that much faster with the new option. For that we select our panorama, and on the right you can find the properties title and subtitle. So you fill these in for each panorama, and then you go to the Skin tab. Let me quickly delete the old stickers so they don't get in the way. Now we select one of the skin elements that have text, so right now that would be label, multi-line label, or even buttons, which are currently the ones supporting dynamic texts. I will select a multi-line text box, and I'm going to simply place it on the top left corner. Now, this is the important part where we introduce the variables which indicate the program to always take the title we gave to the panorama and display it here. Right now, the possible variables are title and subtitle, but we will be adding more. So this is how you would have to type it in with the curly brackets, so it's a demand or a placeholder for the program. And that would already work like this, but I do want to format it a little bit so it looks nicer. First, I change the font type. Then I want another color for the title text. And the subtitle should be white. So as you can see, you can personalize these multi-line text boxes quite a bit, which is obviously great to establish a certain design line for your tours or for a certain client with their style guide and colors, and you don't have to go the extra mile with elements designed outside of 3D Vista. Okay, so this is a design that's already quite similar to our text stickers from before, which were actual images, but the advantage now is that this being a dynamic text box, we only have one element which adapts to each media, and we don't have to import 50 different images like before. Another advantage is that when we do want to change the style of such a label, before, with the old way of doing this, we had to go one by one through each sticker image of each panorama and then change all 50 images and replace the labels one by one in each panorama. Whereas now, we simply change our one multi-line text box, and that's it. Big time saver, and obviously this also keeps your skin a lot more tidy and simple. Let's see how this looks. And as you can see, indeed, it takes the panorama's title and subtitle and displays it in the text box. And as we change to the next panorama, the text changes as well. And that's how fast you can create stickers or labels or buttons using dynamic texts. This option with the title and subtitle is not only available for panoramas, but also for photo albums and videos, so that the text box we just created would also work with those media types and show the title box even when opening a photo album inside the tour or playing a video. We hope you appreciate this new feature and that it helps you to save time and optimize your workflow of creating individualized, high-quality virtual tours. Thanks for watching!